is the chapter number 6. Today I will revise the chapter number 6, Changes Around Us. So there are so many figures shown in this. A person is his nose, and a person is become queen. There are so many changes. These changes can be occur if we have magical powers. But we don't have magical power. So how can these changes be occur? So these changes cannot be occur without magical powers. There are so many changes around you with no magic involved. Many changes are taking place around us on their own. And as we know, in the fish, crop is changing from time to time, and sometimes leaves fall from the trees. So these are the examples of changes. First is leaves fall from the tree and it changes the color. And so there are so many changes around you. As we know, in the fish, crop is changing from time to time, and tea leaves is falling from the trees, and it changes color and it dries out, and the flower blooms and then wither away. As we know, so there are so many changes around us. For example, in the fields, crop is changing from time to time, and the color of crop is also changing from time to time. And when leaves fall from tree, and then it also changes its color. So there are so many changes. As we know, our nails grow, your hair grows, and you grow taller and your weight increases. So there are so many changes around you. Did you realize earlier that so many changes are taking place around you all the time? And can some of the changes be grouped together? So there are so many changes. We have to group these changes if they have similar properties. We can group into the same category. And how can we group various things? So if we find similarity between the changes, so we can define in one category. And so there are so many activities. So we can find in the activity whether it is reversible change or irreversible change. So what is the activity one? Firstly, we are taking a balloon and then we are blowing the balloon and taking care that it does not burst. Firstly, we are taking a balloon and then we are blowing, and then we have to take care that it does not burst. And the shape and size of the balloon have changed. If we blow the balloon, then the shape and size of the balloon is changing. Now let the air escape the balloon. So firstly, we will take a balloon and then we will blow the balloon. And you have to take care that the balloon does not burst. So the balloon does not burst. As we know, the shape and size of the balloon is changing. Now let the air escape the balloon. So firstly, we are taking a balloon, and then if we are blowing the balloon, so you have to take care that it does not burst. So we are taking the balloon and then we are blowing that balloon. So you have to take care that it does not burst. And the shape and size of the balloon is also changing from time to time. And now let the air escape the balloon. So air is escaping into the balloon. So because the balloon, it changes its size and shape when air enters into the balloon. When air enters into the balloon, its size and shape is changing in the activity one. And what is the activity two? Firstly, we are taking a piece of paper and fold it as shown in the figure 6.2. You have changed the sheet of paper into a toy aeroplane. So what is the activity two? We are taking a piece of paper and we are folding this paper as shown in the figure 6.2. We are making a toy aeroplane with the paper. So this is a figure 6.2. We are making the aeroplane, a toy aeroplane made by the folding paper. So what are the changes? This can be reversed. So it is a reversible change. And in the activity one, if we blow the balloon, we can get back the balloon if the air escape from the balloon. So this is irreversible change. So this is a reversible change. So the changes in the activity one and activity two, so this is a reversible change. And next is activity three. So what is activity three? Firstly, we are taking some dough and we are making a bowl. And then we are making the roti from the bowl. Maybe you are not happy with its shape and wish to change it back into a bowl of dough again. Now think about the three changes you observed in the activity one, two, and three, and what do they have in common? So the changes in the activity one, two, and three, these changes are reversible change. So the changes in the activity three, we can get back the dough from the roti because it is not cooked. So we can get back again. So the changes in the activity one, two, and three, so these changes are reversible change. What is activity one? We are blowing the balloon. And then what is activity two? We are making a toy aeroplane by folding paper. And then what is activity three? We are making roti from the dough. So these changes are reversible change. Was it possible to get the balloon back to original shape and size? And was the size of the paper same as before after making an aeroplane? Was it possible to get back the bowl of dough again? What do you conclude? In each of three activities, is it possible to get back to the material with which we started our activity? If the answer is yes, it means that the changes occurring in this activity can be reversed. So the changes occurring in the activity one, two, and three, these can be reversed. And now let us repeat the same activity with the difference. So next is the activity four, five, and six. So what is the activity four? So we are taking the same balloon as we use in the activity one, and then we are blowing this balloon with the mouth, and then we are sending it tightly and with the string, and we are pricking it with the pointed tip of your pencil. Firstly, हम balloon लेते हैं उसको पूरा उसको हम फुलाते हैं, फुलाने के बाद जो ऊपर से उसको हम धागे से बांध देते हैं और उसको pencil से हम pencil की pointed tips को फोड़ते हैं. Oops, it bursts. Yes, it bursts. Can we get back the balloon? No. हम बैलून अब दोबारा नहीं ला सकते क्योंकि वो फूट चुका है. दिस इज अ इरिवर्सिबल चेंज. सो द चेंजेस अकरिंग इन द एक्टिविटी फोर, दिस इज अ इरिवर्सिबल चेंज. सो दिस इज अ इरिवर्सिबल चेंज. नेक्स्ट इज एक्टिविटी फाइव. सो फर्स्टली वी आर टेकिंग द पीस ऑफ पेपर दैट वी यूज्ड इन द एक्टिविटी टू, एंड देन वी आर ड्रॉइंग एन एरोप्लेन ऑन इट, एंड देन वी आर कटिंग इट्स आउटलाइन. So firstly, we are taking the piece of paper and which were used in the activity two, and then we are drawing an aeroplane on it, and then we are cutting its outlining. So firstly, we are taking the same piece of paper and which were used in the activity 2, and then we are drawing an aeroplane on it, and we are cutting its outlining. So this is the activity 5. What is activity 5? Firstly, we are taking the piece of paper, and then we are drawing an aeroplane on it. If we are drawing an aeroplane on it, then we are cutting with the help of scissor. If we cut it with the help of scissor, can we get back again? No, because it is being cut. So this is an irreversible change. So the changes occurring in the activity 4 and 5, this is an irreversible change. And what is activity 6? We are making a roti from the bowl of dough, and then we are baking it on a tawa. If we are baking it on a tawa, then what is these changes? If we are making a roti from the bowl of dough, and then these, what are the changes occurring in the activity 6? What would you answer? Then the changes have occurred in the activity 4, 5, and 6. It cannot be reversed. So the changes we have occurred in the activity 4, 5, 6, these cannot be reversed, means it is irreversible change. So the changes occurring in the activity 4, if we blow the balloon, and if we are blowing it over the full size, and if we are tightly bounded with the help of string, then this changes is called irreversible change. Next is activity 5. We are taking the piece of paper, and then we are making a toy aeroplane. Cutting with the paper. So it cannot be back again because it is being cut. So it is irreversible change. And if we are making roti, agar hum roti bana rahe hain, dough se usko bake kar rahe hain, usko hum dobara hum get nahi kar sakte. So this is also irreversible changes. So the activity 1 and activity 2 and activity 3, these changes are irreversible change. And the changes occurring in the activity 4, 5, 6, this is a irreversible change. So there are 2 changes. First is reversible change, and next is irreversible change. The change which we can get back again is called reversible change, and the change which we cannot back is called irreversible change. So there are so many changes shown in the figure, table 6.1. Changes raw egg to boiled egg. So it can be reversed or not. Better to idli, it can be reversed or not. Wet clothes to dry clothes, it can be reversed or not. And grains to flour, it can be reversed or not. So there are so many changes, and it can be reversed or not. So we are making the batter to idli and wet clothes to dry clothes and grain to flour. So it can be reversed or not, you have to find. So firstly is batter to idli. If we make a idli from the batter, can we back a batter again? No. So it is irreversible change. So if we get the dry clothes from the wet clothes, can we get the wet clothes again? Yes. If we put water on it, then we can get the wet clothes. So this is a reversible change. So there are so many changes. Some are reversible and some are irreversible. Next is, which we have discussed in the last class. This is a tool, and this tool is used for digging the soil. And how it works? The iron plate shown in the figure, it has a ring in which wooden handle is capped. So what is the work, how it works, and how it, what is the construction? It has a wooden handle, and it has an iron blade, and on the iron blade the wooden handle is capped, on which it is fixed. Normally, the ring is slightly smaller in size than the wooden handle, and to fix the handle, the ring is heated and it becomes slightly larger in size. If we heat the ring, then it expands and it becomes larger in size. Now the handle easily fits into the ring. So this handle can fit into the ring, and when the ring cools down, it contracts and fits slightly on the handle. So these are the tools oftenly used before fixing the wooden handles. So these are the tools. When we heat the metal, when we heat any metal, then it expands. So how it works, it has a wooden handle, and on the iron plate, it has a circular ring. So when we heat the circular ring, then it expands, and wooden handle can easily be fit into the ring. So this is a working how this tool works, and what is the purpose of this tool? This tool is used for digging the soil. And such a change is also used for fixing the metal rim on a wooden wheel of the cart as shown in the figure. And again, the metal rim is made slightly smaller than the wooden wheel, and on hitting, the rim expands and fits into the soil, into the wheel. And cold water is then poured over the rim, which contracts and fits tightly onto the wheel. So this is a change. It is used for fixing the metal rim on the wooden wheel. And as we know, the metal rim is made slightly smaller than as compared to the wooden wheel. As we know, the size of metal rim is very, very smaller as compared to the wooden wheel, so that the wooden wheel can fit into the metal rim. So on the wheel, as shown in the figure, this is a wheel. This is a wheel shown in the figure. This is a cart wheel on which metal rim is fixed. This is a metal rim. And when we heat the metal rim, then it expands, and then it fits into the cart wheel. When we heat water in a pan, it begins to boil after some time. If we continue to heat further, the quantity of water in the pan begins to decrease. So firstly, we will take the water, and if we heat the water, then the amount of water decreases. And what is the process going on? Evaporation. So what do you mean by evaporation? The process of changing water into water vapor is called evaporation. And what do you mean by condensation? The process of conversion of water vapor back into water, it is called conversion of water vapor into water. Then what is the change occurring in this? So this is a what is the change occurring is the process. So changing water into water vapor is called evaporation, and conversion of water vapor into water, then this is called condensation. Let us observe more changes. Bujo has often noticed that the road construction worker heat a black material tar for a repairing of road. As we know, for repairing a road, we use a material, black material tar. And he wants to know whether the change caused in the tar by heating, it can be reversed or not. Yes, it can be reversed. Next is, as we know, blacksmith, he uses the pieces of iron and he makes the pieces of tool. He makes the pieces of tool into change into the different tools. And when piece of iron is heated, then it becomes red hot. When the piece of iron is heated and it becomes red hot, and if it becomes soft, then it can be changed into the desired shape. So it can be changed into the desired shape. So as we know, if the blacksmith, he makes some tools, and the blacksmith, he changes a piece of iron into the different tools. And how it changes into different tools? He hits the a pieces of iron, then it becomes soft and it can be beaten into a desired shape. So it can be beaten into a desired shape. Next is activity 7. So firstly, what is activity 7? We are taking a small candle and we are measuring its length with the scale. So firstly, we are taking a candle, then if we are measuring it with the help of scale, and if we now fix it at a suitable place and light it. So firstly, we are taking a small candle and then we are measuring its length with the scale. Now blow out the candle and measure its length again. So firstly, we will take a candle and we are measuring it with the help of scale. And now light the candle and burn it for some time. Then the wax evaporates and the length of the candle decreases. If we heat the candle, then the length of candle decreases. So this is also a change. And can the change in the length of candle be reversed? Yes, if we put more wax on the candle, then it can be changed into the desired length. If we were to take some wax in a pan, as shown in the figure 6.9, if we pour some wax into a pan and if we heat it, then the solution of wax is made. And can we back it again? Yes. If we cool it, we can get back again. So this is called reversible change. And now if we repeat the activity 7 with the incense stick, अगरबत्ती का जो हम यूज करके उसको अगर हम जलाएं, wait till it burns away completely. When it burns completely, then what is the material formed? Ash and some gases is observed when the incense stick is burnt. So the stick burns to produce some new material. So there are so many ash and some gases. And we cannot see these gases, but can sense them due to their pleasant smell. So due to their pleasant smell, we can sense them. And can these changes be reversed? Yes. And what about the change which occurred in the matchstick you use for the lighting the candle or incense stick? So far, we have discussed the changes occurring in a given object or its material. And what about the changes that occur when two substances are mixed together? So these are the example of changes occurring. If we burn the incense stick, then some gases and ash is formed, and the ash and some gases and gases are formed, and which we cannot see these gases, but we can sense these gases due to their pleasant smell. So can these changes be reversed? And what about the change which occurred in the matchstick you use in the lighting or candle or incense stick? So these are the changes occurring, and their gas can be smelled with their pleasant smell. And these are the changes occurring. And what about the change that occurred in matchstick you use for lighting the candle or incense stick? So far, we have discussed the changes occurring in a given object or its material. So if we mix two substances, for example, if we mix the salt into water, then what is the change? Yes, the liquid becomes salty. The water becomes salty. So this is also a change. If we pour some water, if we put some sugar or some salt into the water, then the solution becomes salty. So this is also a change. Can we back it again? Yes. If we heat the solution, what is the changes occurring in? So there are so many changes occurring. If we heat the salt solution, then it evaporates. then the water evaporates and we can get back the salt. So yes, the next is Paheli asks if you have ever seen curd being said. So how curd is made? If we add some small amount of curd and if we add small amount of curd into the warm milk, so what is the change occurring in this? So the milk is changing into the curd. So milk is changing into the curd. So and in this process, how curd is made? So can we back it again? No. With the help of curd, we cannot back the milk. So this is irreversible changes. So they are categorized into two. First is reversible change and next is irreversible change. So next is, these are the keywords, changes, contraction, evaporation, expansion, and melting. So you can write in on the notebook. We have discussed the evaporation, the process of conversion of water into water vapor is called evaporation. And what do you mean by melting? The process of conversion, what is the process going on? This is evaporation. The process of conversion of water into water vapor is called evaporation. And what is contraction? If we heat any material, then the size of the metal is increases, means it is contraction. And what do you mean by melting? If we heat any substance, then the melting process is going on. So this is summary. So some changes that are reversed and some are cannot be reversed. So this is the definition of change, and some are reversible change and some are irreversible change. So in the next lecture, we will discuss this question. So you have to write these keywords in your notebook and you have to find the internal question of this lesson and you have to write it on the notebook. So if you have any query regarding this topic or this lesson, you can ask in this lecture. If you have any query regarding this topic, you can ask in this lecture. Yes. Yes, any query regarding this topic, raise your hands. Yes, reach roll number 30. Akash sir, please unmute student.